Hi there guys, hope you're doing well. This is your friend and tutor Manas. So let's see what this problem has in store. Here we go.
A bar of weight 100 Newton is hinged at A and is pulled by a cable attached at B by a force F. Find the force F and the magnitude and direction of the reaction at A if the bar is in equilibrium position as shown in the figure. Alright, so to begin, let me explain you this arrangement. Now there is this bar AB and it has been hinged at A. Now this hinge support is such that it will restrict the motion of the bar both in the horizontal as well as in the vertical direction. And hence you're gonna have two different sorts of forces, one in the horizontal sense this way. Okay, let us say that this is HA and one in the vertical direction, something of this sort. Okay. So this is gonna be VA, right? Now this is the bar AB and it has some self weight of 100 Newtons. Now this weight is acting in the downward direction, then obviously this bar will have a tendency to fall down. And in order to prevent this, what we have done is there is a force F which has been applied in somewhat this direction at an angle of 30 degree with the length of this bar. Now the idea of having this force is to counter this weight, or is to prevent the bar AB from falling. All right. Now let's go ahead and find this value of force F and also the overall resultant at point A. Alright, so what initially I'm going to be doing is, please have a careful look at this. You can see that this line over here and this line, both these lines are absolutely parallel. Then you can say that this AB acts as a transversal. So if this AB is acting as a transversal and this angle over here is 45 degree, then the entire angle over here also will work out as 45 degrees, out of which this much already we know is 30 degrees. Then this much angle shall work out as 15 degrees, because 30 plus 15 will get you 45 degrees. All right. Now this way we can resolve the forces. If this is force F at an angle of 15 degree with this horizontal, then obviously the force is going to have a horizontal component in this direction. This is going to be what you call F cos 15. And this force is also going to have a vertical component over here this way. Now this is what you call F sine 15. All right, the resolution of forces is over. Now we'll go ahead and try to calculate HA, VA and F. Now three unknowns, and for three unknowns, we have three equations of equilibrium. So I'm going to start off with what you call the moment equation. Okay, summation of moment of all the forces about any point is equal to zero. And that the point that I'm going to select is point A about the hinge. So let me just write it down, moment about A is equal to zero. Okay, let's have the forces. You see this force F cos 15, all right, F cos 15. If this is the force, and if you were to drop a perpendicular from point A, this will be that perpendicular. All right, something of this sort. Let us say that this point is C. Okay, so this is the force F cos 15 multiplied by this perpendicular distance AC. So let me just write it down, F cos 15 multiplied by AC. Now let us try to sort the nature of this moment. Now if you keep your right hand thumb over here and try to move your baby finger along this direction, you'll realize this force produces an anti-clockwise moment, and anti-clockwise moment is to be taken as positive in nature. All right, moving ahead, let us work out the moment of this force F sine 15. So this is F sine 15. Okay. And this is the line of action for F sine 15. Then you have to drop a perpendicular from this point A. And when you do so, it's going to end up here. Okay. Let us say that this point is D. So this is force F sine 15 multiplied by this perpendicular distance AD. So F sine 15. So this force is producing a clockwise moment. Let me tell you why. Keep your right hand thumb over here and try to move your baby finger along this direction. It will produce a clockwise moment. Clockwise moment means negative sign. Name of the force, F sine 15 multiplied by, let us check that again. F sine 15 multiplied by this perpendicular distance AD. All right. So let's write AD over here. What's left? Okay, so this W is equal to 100 Newtons is still left. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be extending this in the downward direction, something of this sort. Okay, so it intersects over here, and this is the force. And if you were to drop a perpendicular on this force, this will be that perpendicular. And let us say that the point is E. So force is 100 newtons in the downward direction, and this is perpendicular distance AE. Keep your right hand thumb over here and try to move your baby finger along this direction. You'll realize this force produces a clockwise moment and has to be taken as negative over here. So 100 multiplied by AE. Now, what's left? Now, HA and VA, both of them are passing through point A, and point A is that point about which the moment is supposed to be taken. And hence, these two forces are going to have their moment equal to zero. All right. So that's it. And now equating all of them equal to zero, we have to solve this equation and get the value of this force F, which counters this weight W, so that everything stays in equilibrium. The bar maintains this angle of 45 degrees with the horizontal forever and ever. All right. Now guys, please watch this carefully. Okay, this is some trigonometry I'm going to be introducing. AC. All right, so we have to get the value of AC. Where is AC? So this is AC. AC. Now look carefully. AC seems to be a part of this triangle, this right angle triangle over here. Please see where the mouse is hovering. This is AC is a part of this triangle. Okay, and this much angle we know very well is 45 degrees. Okay, if this is AB, okay, then this is going to be AB cos 45 and this is going to be AB sin 45. All right. So let us just write down AC is equal to AB sin 45. I'm going to be putting this value in this equation. All right. All of them are going to be related in terms of AB only. Okay. Now comes the turn of AD. Where is AD? Okay. So if you watch carefully, this is AD. And AD actually is a part of this triangle. Okay, please watch where the mouse is hovering. AD is a part of this triangle over here. Now, this is AB. This is AB. This angle is 45. Okay, then this has got to be AB cos 45. Then AD is equal to AB cos 45. Let me write it down. AD is equal to AB cos 45. What else? Okay. Now, the next thing that we are supposed to calculate is this AE. Okay, so where is AE? This is AE. Now, AE seems to me a part of this triangle over here. There is no name at this point. What name shall I give over here? Let us say that this is M. Okay, this point is M. Okay, now AE is a part of this triangle. Simply, this is AM, and you can also refer to AM as AB over 2. Okay, this is exactly at the center of this bar AB. So if it is at the center, then this distance AM is going to be AB over 2. If this is AB by 2, then this has got to be AB by 2 cos 45 and this has got to be AB by 2 sin 45. And we are interested in calculating the value of AE. So AE shall work out as AB by 2 cos 45. So now you have got all these values in terms of AB and you need to put them over here to calculate the final value of F. So let us try to do that quickly. F cos 15, all right, multiplied by what is AC? Where is AC? Where is AC? AC is AB sin 45. AB sin 45 minus again F sin 15 multiplied by what is AD? Where is AD? AD is AB cos 45. So let us write down AB cos 45 minus 100 times of AE. Where is AE? AE, wherever written down AE, is equal to AB by 2 cos 45. So AB by 2 cos 45 and everything ultimately will be equal to 0. You just need to solve this equation. It's pretty simple. Now in the next step, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this F as common and I'll write down the remaining stuff. Sin 45 cos 15 minus cos 45 sin 15. Okay, and also AB was common and we're gonna shift this. So 2 times of 50 is 100 and this is 50 AB cos 45. So let us write this down, 50 AB cos 45. So AB and AB cancel out. And this is a very popular formula, sin A cos B cos A sin B, and with a negative sign in between. So sin A cos B minus cos A sin B, sin of A minus B. So let me write this, F of sin of 45 minus 15, okay, is equal to 50 cos 45. And if you were to calculate the value of f, it should work out as, I'm going to shift this over to this side. Okay, so it is going to be equal to 50 cos 45 whole divided by this 45 minus 15 is 30 sine of 30. And when you try to put this into a calculator, you're going to eventually get the value of f is equal to, let me write this, f is equal to 70.7 newtons, okay, approximately. So that's the value of f calculated. Okay, our task is far from over and we have to get the values of HA and VA. Okay, so how can that be done? I'm going to be using this second equation of equilibrium, summation of all the forces in x direction equal to zero. So what are they? So we have this HA in the right hand side direction, so it has to be taken as positive. So just let us write that down. HA, f cos 15, left hand side direction, negative. Okay, so minus f cos 15. What else is there? Okay, nothing, is equal to zero. Then obviously the value of H A is going to be equal to f cos 15, and you know very well the value of f is equal to 70.7. and when you put this value, you are going to get the value of HA equal to 68.3 newtons. So this is the value of HA. Okay, now let's finally do this. Summation of f of y is equal to zero, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this VA. So upward direction and has to be taken as positive. So VA, what else is there? We have 100 newtons in the downward direction. We have f sine 15 in the downward direction. So both of them are to be taken in the form of negative, minus 100 minus f sine 15. Everything equals to zero. Okay. And ultimately the value of VA shall be equal to 100 plus f sine 15. You just need to put the value of f is equal to 70.7 over here and do this little calculation onto a calculator, and you're going to figure out the value of VA is equal to 118.3 newtons. That's it. Now the next step is to find the overall resultant at A. So the resultant is going to be somewhere something like this. So this is the resultant. Okay, so the resultant is going to be RA, and there is a specific formula for getting the value of RA. Now RA is equal to under root of HA square plus VA square, and when you put in all these values, you're going to eventually get the value of RA is equal to 136.6 newton. You can also get the value of this angle. Let us say that this angle is alpha. Okay, you can calculate this alpha, the angle that the resultant makes with this horizontal, and tan alpha is equal to what? VA over HA. Okay, when you put in the values, you're going to get this. VA is how much? 118.3 divided by 68.3, and eventually alpha works out as, let me tell you, approximately it is 60 degrees. Okay, so this angle is actually 60 degrees. So that's all for today.
So guys, that was all from my side for today. If you like the content and presentation in this video, do give it a big thumbs up. And if you believe that this video tutorial has added value to your knowledge of mechanics, then do recommend this channel to your friends and classmates so that all of them can benefit. I'll see you again with a new problem. Until then, it's a wrap. This is Manas Patnaik signing off. Take care, have a great day, and keep learning.